for my first stream of 2019. I apologize for the wait, just, you know, stuff being busy, and well, I'm back, so, and I'm actually returning with a character design challenge. This month's challenge is Warrior Mice, so I just kind of did a fun young mouse adventurer, sword and shield, off to find, well, mostly fun, you know. Kind of went for like a Legend of Zelda Skyrim inspired outfit, so yeah, just start a bit of the line art, so we're gonna continue with that and see how things go. Hope everyone's been doing well and that your 2019 is going well too. Let's all make the best of it. I wanted to go this route because I've been drawing, you know, a lot of kimono stuff already, so I didn't want to do... Well, I could have done samurai with the armor instead, but I don't know, I was kind of also feeling, just because I've been playing a lot of Smash Bros, kind of feeling going for, you know, Zelda tunic idea. And there's a bit of that incorporated here, as well as some of the armors from Skyrim, particularly the hide armor. Hide and scaled armor, well, particularly hide armor. Well, hard armor is actually, I think, one of the worst, like, worst subject. Stats-wise, one of the worst armors, but I always like the look of it, so. I always try to get, like, an enchanted hide armor if I'm running a light armor character, just so I can have that as a fun outfit alternative, and really boost up those, those light armor perks. Wow, I need to play Skyrim. It's actually been years since I played it. Still on my list. But yeah, I'm just still getting my live streaming stuff, you know, a bit more organized. Doing just something simple tonight. I usually stream on Saturdays, but I've been, you know, Saturdays have been busy last few weeks. Like last night, you know, Saturday night, you're watching this live, I had, I made soup with my older brother. We made a tortilla soup, and that's a very simple recipe, a bit messy, but very, very good. I had that for lunch today, and yeah, I really enjoy cooking. Hope everyone else is having a good time. This will probably be a short stream, short and quiet. Well, it's shaping out to be quiet. It's not. Don't know how many people are popping up. I don't know why it always takes me so long to get to these character design challenges. I end up doing them in the last few days of the month. At least that's the pattern's been so far. When I have been able to do them. Yeah, I've been keeping busy with a lot of art that I've been posting here and there. Always good practice. Also getting really busy with playing Smash Bros. Ultimate. Just really enjoying the adventure mode and all the spirit board challenges. Well, I shouldn't say enjoying all, because some of those are just like brutally unfair. And hideously obnoxious. Ugh. There are some, though, you can, finesse in a way. Like, one of the hardest challenges I came across was the one for unlocking the spirit for Pauline from Super Mario Odyssey. And this challenge is just designed in the worst, in so many terrible bits. So the map you have to do it on is on the, I think it's called 35-bit, the one that's based off the original Donkey Kong game, which is a big map that you have to jump around a lot to get to from platform to platform. And so part of the challenge is you have a reduced jump, and you have to take out a Peach that keeps moving around, like just one of those conflict avoidance NPCs. And she's guarded by a Mario that starts off with a hammer and a giant Donkey Kong, so already just are in for a world of hurt. And a reduced jump in a very jump-heavy level. And there's a minute and a half time limit. So it's... And this is a Legend level challenge, which are like the hardest ones in the game. And it is so baloney. I hated it so much. But there is a way to... You can easily beat it if you do this strategy. So there's a weapon in the game called the staff, which functions as pretty much as a sniper rifle. I don't know what game it's from, but it looks... Well, I haven't used it much, except for I really just kind of learned about in this challenge, is that it seems to have it seems to do more damage the further away it's fired. So in this particular map, you start on the opposite side of the stage as Peach. And you only have to take out the Peach to beat the challenge. You really don't need to take out Mario or Donkey Kong to win. So use the sniper rifle, and in two hits you can knock Peach off the stage at the very start of the level, which is kind of amazing. And actually, I looked it up on how it's done, and the video looked easy enough. And then I tried it, and it was absolutely that easy. So one of the most annoying, aggravating, and difficult challenges in the game can be really easily bypassed by one item and a few perks. So yeah. And she's also the spirit's a very good spirit too. She takes up two slots. She's a support spirit, not a primary one. And what the spirit allows you to do is if you shield an attack, you gain a little bit of health, which can be handy. So yeah. I've always liked fingerless gloves. I don't know why. Well, probably goes back to Ocarina of Time, like a lot of things do for me. trying to decide what kind of fur color this mouse will have when everything's, when I get to that point. Leading towards a light gray, but I don't know for sure. Yes. Ooh, that's not right. Kind of wanted to put little studs here on the belts. I can make that come across. Very big studs. Not sure how that's supposed to look. Well, oh. Oh, and then there's the tail, which I always make sure I do also. Oh, how'd that get erased? Okay, now I need to do the legs. Good. Bit of a quiet stream. I just really wanted to get one done because of the long break I've been having. Yeah, hoping to get a lot more streaming and stuff and video content done in 2019. Hopefully that'll happen, but we'll see. Just need to really plan that out more, but yeah. Wish me luck. Had a lot of trouble getting the boots to look right. Especially this one, because it's at an angle I'm not used to. Hopefully what I did works. No, it's just simple boots. I really have trouble with shoes. Still have until the 31st to finish this, so I won't finish this tonight, but I should be able to get it done by then. Odd how those eraser shavings in the scan formed a letter F, but all right. Forgot to separate that bin. This is hurt later, and I forgot to add part of this sash here in the armor or belt bit. Because the sword scabbard is held by a separate belt. Got my basic line art done, so now I need to start getting some bits ready for shading and coloring. Ooh, don't know how that happened. Yeah, that boot doesn't look great. I'm gonna adjust that some more. And I missed a bit already. Not a muscular worm, I'm going for a young adventurer, kind of. Kind of early stage of the RPG story. Maybe it's working, I'm not sure. Not having fun with it, and I missed that bit, but it's okay, I can get that later. Okay. That to help with the shading. Now let's get some color here. Painted. Well. I'll adjust that later. All right. Maybe the scabbard bits attached to the armor. I just noticed that that strap's kind of weird, but oh well. Let me try that. Okay. Alright, I think that's a good start so far. Alright, I'm gonna take a break now. Hope everyone has a great evening, great whatever time of day you see this later. And I'll get this done in the next few days. And yeah, I'll see you all next time. Bye bye.